Hey guys, welcome to today's video. We're talking about easy marketing strategies for dog trainers at home. I started my dog training business, Matador Canine Brilliance, during the height of COVID. So we couldn't go out, we couldn't go do things that, you know, business owners were able to do beforehand, going to the dog park and mom and pop shops. All of that was shut down. So I had to figure out how to use marketing strategies in a more confined space. And it turned out that that was way more effective. It was a better use of my time. I had to get better at marketing in general. And today I want to go over 10 marketing strategies that I personally use in my business and what you should be using in your business to grow it and scale it to the dream business that you have in mind. We're going to go over 10 marketing strategies. And at the end, I'm going to rate the 5 that you should definitely start with and their difficulties and the 5 that you should wait until you have some inflow and some, you know, income coming in, and then you can start focusing more of your attention on that. So stay tuned until the end. First up, we have website traffic. This is what a lot of people start with. They try to write blogs, they make a website, they're focused on SEO content. Increasingly more is website traffic garbage. With the invention of AI, and I started with website traffic. I tried to get a great website and I tried to do blog posts and I was doing a blog post every single day. The invention of AI has made that pretty much obsolete. All right, when I go to Google now and I type in how to train my dog, or I'm type in, you know, how to cook pasta, I don't look for articles anymore. I'm getting AI generated content at the top of the page. If you haven't seen this on Google yet, it is very, very new, but it is going to be the future of, search content in that kind of respect. All right. Second is social media. This is an absolute buzzword when it comes to easy marketing strategies. Oh, just post on social media. Well, even the best gurus in the world, Gary Vaynerchuk, Grant Cardone, right? They're saying, hey, post for 7 years, then come back to me and tell me it's not working. Okay, well, I don't have 7 years to wait. And I didn't have 7 years to wait when I started my business during the height of COVID. So social media is fantastic if you're trying to grow a brand awareness, which is different than direct response marketing, right? It's great if you're trying to be everywhere all at once and get people to see your face, but it does not work in running a successful business, especially when you're starting out. You need to take the more direct response approach. Every dollar you put into content and ads and getting your name out there, you need to get at least $2 back, if not more, right? Social media, you can't do that. Right? You could spend, let's say, an entire weekend filming content and you go put it out into the world and it might flop. Now, this is different than our third marketing strategy, which is video marketing. Social media over here, video marketing over here. Why? Social media, once you put something up, within a week, it's completely dead. It's not going to revive. It's not going to come back. It is dead unless it's a viral video and it has legs, right? It just hangs on for a really long time. Video marketing can do that. Right? You post on YouTube, which is a search engine, not a social media platform. It's a search engine. Somebody goes, how to train my dog on YouTube. You could pop up. It's very competitive. So you need to find a certain strategy that works for you and pick a very particular niche, right? How to train my dog at home. That's a long keyword phrase. And I'm getting a little more technical here. But video marketing in that respect is much more effective than social media. So if you only have the weekends to build your dog training business and you're doing something else during the week, focus 100% on video marketing. Those videos are going to build your authority, build the respect, and then you can ask them to opt in for number 4, which is our email list. But before I get to the email list, video marketing, last thing about video marketing, any big dog trainer you see all have YouTube channels. You might find them on social media, but they got big on their YouTube channel or other video marketing platform as they may come up. They did not get big on social media first. They got big on YouTube first and then moved over to social media because they had the free time. They were like, oh, I'm doing really well in my business. Now I can focus on social media. So number 4 was that email. Every single business has an email list. And the rule of thumb here, if you really want to, you know, get granular and think about the statistics and the math, is for every one person you have on your email list, you will make $1 per month per person. So if you've got 100 people on your email list, you're only going to make $100. If you have 1,000 people on your email list, you're going to make $1,000 a month. If you want to make $10,000 a month, you need to have 10,000 people on your email list. This is a general rule of thumb. So long as your emails are not just promotion, 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 that's not going to work. You have to build a relationship, and the email allows you to do that. Going back to video marketing, you can send them the videos that you're creating. which will not only build the value in their mind and the authority, oh, this guy's got a YouTube channel, this gal's got a YouTube channel, I'm going to go watch their YouTube and get help, get the value from the videos. Now you can talk about other things. So you know, maybe on Monday you post a video and you send it out in your email list, and then Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, you talk about the video. Maybe there's different aspects of the video that you can dissect in more detail throughout the week. Maybe you talk about promotions. Maybe you talk about what's going on in your life so you can build rapport with them. Email is a fantastic, fantastic tool. If you're not using it, you need to. Moving on to number five, gifts and what I call big bone offers. These are big, juicy bone offers. These are amazing things that when you put it out into the world, people have to talk about it. They're like, oh my God, this is such an amazing thing. I can't believe it's at that price. I need to go tell everybody about it. You've worked with a business. Maybe you've bought something before and you immediately go tell someone about it. Every time I learn something that's really valuable, whether I read a book or I watch a course, I attend a webinar, I immediately go tell people about it because I think they should have the same benefit that I'm getting. If you have a big bone offer, you have something that's really good, it's a no-brainer. People are going to talk about it. That's one of the first things that I look for when I'm working with dog trainers on what we can fix in their business. They're like, oh, well, we just do one-on-one training. Okay, that's not a big bone offer. That's a core offer. How do we embellish it? How do we make it that much better? Right? What are the bonuses included? How can we add more value? That's how you get a big bone offer. Create that in your business and it will practically sell itself. Six, ads. Everybody talks about ads when they want to grow a business fast. And yes, putting money in, you will get money out so long that you know how to do it. I just did a video on it, so I'm going to link that below. We're going to move on to number seven, webinars. Webinars, people think are dead. I don't think webinars are dead. I think they've slowed down because everybody was doing them during COVID. Now live events are coming back, and with that, webinars will make a comeback. Webinars are not how they used to be. Webinars used to be a lot of teaching, 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 teaching. Then they turned into a lot of selling, 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 right? Like a little bit of teaching, and then I'm going to try to sell you the entire webinar. What you should be focusing on now is a perfect mix, more so, maybe like 80-20, of teaching and selling. The teaching should be, I'm going to teach you one concept, the one thing that's going to take you from point A to point B. And then the selling is how to do the rest of the way, right? We do want to make a transformation. They have to get value out of the webinar, where the sales, the call to action at the end of the webinar, and it should only be at the end, the call to action at the end isn't going to be effective because they're like, well, I didn't really learn anything. There is a very great way to build out a webinar. I'm going to make a video on it shortly. Stay tuned for that. Make sure you subscribe to make sure you don't miss it. Number eight, affiliate marketing. Affiliate marketing is a great way to multiply your business. You're one person. Trying to do everything by yourself is insanely difficult. Trying to run ads, email, YouTube, all that stuff. If you can get other people to do those things for you, you have effectively used affiliate marketing. What do I mean? Let's say me, myself, and I only focus on video marketing. I'm going to make YouTube videos. But my affiliate marketers, one of them is really great at ads. And they run ads to my business because they get a commission. I don't have to worry about ads anymore. They can worry about ads because they know how to do it. They get a commission. I get to grow my business. Let's say I also have somebody over here who's amazing at big bone offers. Let's say they have a complementary business to myself. So now we can make a better offer, more value by combining their offer with my offer. Now I have somebody who's I'm going to leverage their audience and bring them into my audience, onto my email list, and I can market to them again. Affiliate marketing, if you can manage it, if you can do it, is a fantastic way to scale your business. Number nine, cold prospecting. This is what most people do early on in the beginning. It takes the most amount of effort. You get burned out very quickly. The ROI, the return on investment, is very low. And usually it's not worth it. There's other ways to market your business, like we just talked about the other eight, that you can do way more effectively than cold prospecting. And if you're locked inside your house for lockdown or you can't go out or whatever it is, you're trying to do this all at home, cold prospecting is going to be very difficult. Cold prospecting is when you get on the phone and you call everybody you know, you make a power base, a list of people that you know, and you call them and say, hey, this is what I'm doing. I started a dog training business, or you know, things are slow. I was wondering if you had a dog or you know someone who has a dog. And you do that 500 times a day. You're going to get rejected. People are going to say, stop calling me. People are going to say, hey, why didn't you call? Why didn't you talk to me since high school? Why are you calling me now? It's not worth it. Most people burn out, and that's why they don't grow a business. They give up on that. There's no way I'm going to make 500 phone calls a day and get just slammed every single time. Sure, it builds character, and I did it to start my business, but it was not what I should have been doing. I should have focused on the other things that we're talking about today. And number 10, one of my absolute favorites, is reviews and referrals. I made a video talking about this, and I'm going to talk about it because it's so, so powerful. If you can get reviews in your business, the testimonials that you get, the referrals that you get, are always going to produce better clients. If I'm doing a sales presentation, I'm talking to somebody and I bring up a testimonial and I show them, I'm doing a webinar, I'm doing emails, I'm doing ads, whatever it is, if I can show them a testimonial, that potential client is so much more likely to say, yes, I'm interested, because they know it worked for somebody else and it could most likely work for them. It is one of the best things that you could do for your business is getting more referrals, getting more reviews, especially if you're starting out. Don't charge anybody anything. Just get the 10 to 15 reviews of people 100% free. Then you can start charging money and say, hey, I had results for these people. This is what the results were in their own words. Do you want to do it? Yes or no? Now let's get to the ranking. All right. This is the level of difficulty in order that you should start with. As I just mentioned, number one, reviews and referrals, absolutely essential in your business. Every single person you talk to, you should get a testimonial out. Even if you're just giving them something for free, you're giving them a book, a mini course, you're doing full-on six-month training with them, get a testimonial out of them so that you can grow your business. If you're uncomfortable with it, make up a script, pretend to be somebody else, right? Write something out that you can ask. Hey, while we're talking about this, is anything come to mind that you really enjoyed about our training? Is there anything that you didn't like? And then take the piece that they really enjoyed about training, that becomes a testimonial. What they didn't like, that becomes a critique for you to improve your business later on. Number two in level of difficulty is email. Super simple. Once a week, I sit down and I write down the 5 emails for the week. I have a structure to it where I talk about educational content. I talk about my life and what's going on in the industry. I talk about how-tos, Q&As, and I post my video marketing, which is number 3 in level of difficulty. All you got to use is your phone. Pull out your phone, record what you're doing, put it on a stand, put it against something, you record with your dog, maybe you just talk a couple of times, do a talking head video versus a third-person training video. You can make it your own style. Find out what you like to watch, right? What do you watch on YouTube, if you watch YouTube? What do you enjoy on social media? And then replicate it. You don't have to reinvent the wheel. You just have to take what's uniquely yours and match it with something that you really like. It'll be so easy to do. And then you want to stick to a constant schedule, once a week, twice a week, once a month, whatever you can do. Clearly, the more you do, the faster you're going to progress. But if you can only manage once a month, then do once a month. Number 4 in level of difficulty is social media. Social media is difficult to grow, but it does happen. Right? And the way you want to do this is you want to grow your audience on social media, try to get that virality going, and then send them to the video marketing. The video marketing gets boosted by the emails, and the emails get boosted by the referrals, right? There's a stack to this. So in my emails, I'm going to talk about my reviews. In my emails, I'm going to talk about my video marketing. In my video marketing, I'm going to talk about the reviews so I can build authority. My social media, I'm going to talk about the video marketing so I can get people back and subscribed onto my YouTube channel. And then the YouTube channel is going to say, hey, join my email list for this free thing. And then once they get the free thing, then they're going to get reviews and referrals from that free thing. I'm going to grow my business. See how it all pieces together here. Number 5, the gifts and big bone offers. If you have something really, really good, give it away as a gift. Right? Auction it off on your social media, auction it off on your video marketing, and tell people about this amazing offer that you have. The more you spread this amazing offer that truly is amazing, if it's not amazing, it's not going to work. It has to be packed with value, so much so that it speaks for itself. All right, so that's the first 5. If you're starting a business or you're starting to grow your business, reviews and referrals, emails, video marketing, social media, and gifts and big bone offers. It's the only thing you should focus on. If you're at that stage in your in your career, stop watching, only go focus on those 5 in that order. Get reviews, start building out your email list and rapport with your potential clients, video marketing, social media, gifts and big bone offers. Now, if you're trying to scale a dog training business or you're trying to bring on more people or you're trying to get more in, then you're gonna focus on these next 5. Number 6, affiliate marketing. Start building out a program. Not only building out the options, hey, we're gonna do 20% commission, we're gonna do 40% commission, whatever it is, but also trainings, right? You're gonna have a percentage of affiliate marketers who are really good at affiliate marketing, and they're going to do their own thing and you're not going to have to worry about them. But a lot of people who are joining your affiliate marketing program are going to need a little boost. They're going to need to learn, what is the offer? How do I market it? How do I work with the system that you have, whatever dashboard you have, or if there is a dashboard, right? You want to do some type of training. So that could be a very quick screen share. Show them what they're going to get out of it. Number 7, website traffic. Once you start making money, you could pay somebody to improve your website. But although it might do well, understand that AI is coming in hot, all right? So website traffic, maybe you just scratch that off and you go focus on the other things. Webinars, when you have a big email list, when you have a big audience, you tell them, hey, I'm doing this free webinar on this particular topic, how to blank without blank, how to train my dog without punishment, how to stop my dog from barking without being embarrassed, whatever it may be, right? How to take my dog for a walk without getting pulled. The webinar is going to teach and build value, and then you sell something on the back end. To master that, you have to do it a lot. You have to drive ads to the webinar. There's a lot that goes into building a really efficient webinar, especially if you're trying to sell something at the end. You can't just talk lackadaisically. You kind of have to have a script. You have to have practice. And for that, you need the time to devote to the webinar. So if your business isn't running well, don't start focusing on the webinar. Number 9, ads. You now have money. You now know what works. You validated your offer. You have an email marketing strategy so you can follow up with these individuals that are contacting you through the ads. Now you can start running ads. And number 10 is that cold prospecting. At the bottom of the list is cold prospecting simply because of how difficult it is. If you can't get your business any bigger, then you start paying people, say, hey, go knock on doors and get my business going because I just got to get that extra 10%. And that's what will happen with the cold prospecting. Thank you guys for tuning in today. I hope you found some value out of the easy marketing strategies for dog trainers at home that I've talked about in this video. If you have questions, put them down in the comments, subscribe, hit the notification bell so you never miss another episode, and I'll see you next time.